Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, my name is Yusrandeska Putra Tanjung. In this occasion, I would like to present my presentation by the title Recontext. To the first material, that is definition. The definition of recontext. Recontext is a text which retells the event or experience in the past. So, if you want to retell about your holiday or special event to your friend, so you can use recontext. The second is generic structure. In the recontext, there is three generic structure. The first is orientation, the second is event, and the last is reorientation. In orientation, the writer tells about what, who, when, and where about the story. And in the event, writer tells about what happened in the story in sequence. And the last is reorientation. In the reorientations, the writer tells comment about the story. But remember, reorientation is optional, so you can make the recontext with reorientation or without reorientation. Now we will talk about language features. The tenses of recontext is past tense, but we can include another tenses like simple present or past continuous. But the main tenses of recontext is past tense because recontext is a text which retells something in the past. In the recontext, we should use chronological connecting such as then, first, second, and another. Now we will talk about the example and analysis, and I'll give you the example. There are four paragraphs here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. In the first paragraph is orientation, and the second and third paragraph are event, and the last paragraph is reorientation. In the first paragraph is talking about who, when, and where about the story, and it is called orientation. And in the second and third paragraph are talking about the event in sequence, and that is called event. And in the last paragraph, there is comment that is given by writer, and that is called reorientation. Thank you very much for your nice attention. And the last essay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.